Hello, Dan Nedelkovsky here from howtomechatronics.com. This will be a step-by-step video tutorial for controlling the Arduino board using Matlab GUI or Graphic User Interface. We will make a Matlab GUI with two buttons for turning on and off the LED and an axis for plotting the analog input from the photocell. Here's the circuit schematic of this example. So we have one analog input coming from the photocell and one digital output for the LED. This is the basic principle of communication between the Arduino and the Matlab that we are going to use for this example. In order to enable the communication, we will have to install the Arduino input-output package library. If you haven't already done that, I would highly recommend watching my step-by-step video tutorial for installing and enabling the communication between the Arduino board and Matlab. You can click here to watch that tutorial first, or if you have already done that, now we will start building the Matlab GUI. We can create a Matlab graphic user interface by clicking here, New. Graphic User Interface. We will choose a blank GUI. And here is the GUI editor. First, we will set an axis where we will show the analog inputs. Okay. Now we will need to push buttons for controlling the LED. Here's one button for turning on and another button for turning off the LED. We will rename them later. Okay. And another button for reading the analog inputs, which will depend on from this edit text here. In this edit text, we will set how many samples we will read from the analog inputs. Okay, now we have to modify these buttons by double clicking them. Here this pop up the properties for this button. First we will rename this here, the string. So this is what it appears on the button. I will name it turn on. And also I will change the name of this here, the tag, which will show up later in the script when we will modify the code of the script of this GUI. I will name this one as well turn on button. Okay, here we can see that now the button says turn on and the other button will be turn off. This one as well, turn off button. This button I will rename it read button. Okay, and I will name it this edit text as well. I will name it edit text samples. Okay, so now we have to save this. I will name it example one, and here we can see that a script is automatically generated, and now we can modify this script in order to enable the Arduino board to communicate to this Matlab GUI. First thing we need to do is to create a variable, a global variable, which will enable the serial communication of the Arduino board, and as well define the pin number 8 for the LED as an output. We will do that here in this opening function. We will do that like this. we will write global A. So this A variable, we will use this function Arduino, and we will set the COM port. You should check on what COM port is your Arduino connected. Mine is on number 4, so I will have it like this. And now we will define the pin mode for the pin number 8, and it will be output. Okay, now it is always good to make sure that the port is always clear. So previously, so that's why we will use above these lines, we will use this clear function. So we will make sure that the variable is clear, as well as the port, using this function. Okay, so this will make sure that the port is clean and the variable is clean before we start the new ones. Okay, next is the we will enable the buttons to do something when we will press them. So that will be turning on and turning off the LED. Here is the function for the button turn on. So here we will first restate the global variable, and we will make a digital write. So when this button is pressed, we will make a digital write to pin number 8, and we will set it on a high state, and that will turn on the LED. And here the callback for the turn off button is this function. We will do it the same here. So here we will write a low state or 0 for turning off the LED when this button is pressed. Okay, next is the read button, but before we modify that function, we have to modify here this function. That's the edit text function callback. So we need to handle the value that we will enter into the edit text box and put it into a variable. We will do that like this. We will put it into a variable. I will name it data1, and using this get function, we will put what we will enter in the text box as a string in this data1 variable. But now we have to convert it into a double so that we can use it later. We do it like this. We will put it into a variable. I will name it like this, examples. So string to double. And also we need to write one more line in order to this whole function to work. Okay, so now let's modify this function for the read button. First I will again restate the variable A as well as another key variable that I will use for the loop function, and I need a variable X. Okay, so first we will make a for loop for reading the analog inputs. So this for loop will start at 1 and it will increase by 1 and it will go up to the value that we will enter in the text box. And that will be this x simples value, which is a double that we defined in the previous step. Okay, so now in this variable b, we will read the analog input from pin number 0. And we will store the reads into an array. And now we will plot that array, and it will be automatically attached to the axis that we created in the GUI editor. So we will make just some tuning of the plot of the axis. And we will set a grid on for better visualization. And here we will also set size of the axis. It will go from zero value to the value that we will enter as a samples. And for the epsilon axis, it will go from 0 to 500. This is the values that I was getting from the photo resistor, so they range from 0 to 500. That's why I set these numbers, and we'll make a little delay here. And we will end the for loop. Now one more time, let's see how this example works.